In this video, I'm gonna be breaking down every single type of Google ad that you can make in the Google Ads dashboard. I'm gonna be showing you examples of each so that you don't get lost, because I know that when I coach and I teach people and I'm talking about performance max and search and display and video, they're like, what does this one look like? What does that one look like? So I thought I'd just make this video so you can see what each and every single one looks like, with a detailed explanation of how to make them. Now, if you're brand new to this channel, welcome. My name is Devon, and it's my job to teach you everything I know about Google Ads. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, also the bell button, so you can get notified when I drop new Google Ads tutorials, which I do quite often on this channel. So, I've got my laptop. It's time for us to go to work and figure out which ads are which in Google Ads. Now, I want you to go to New Campaign. And under New Campaign, you're going to see a whole bunch of campaign objectives. So for most of you, you'd be interested in either sales, leads, or website traffic. For now, I'm just going to choose leads. And as you can see, it gives me all of these conversion goals. Now, magic rule of thumb, if you find any of these goals unvaluable to you, for example, if somebody reads to the end of your blog page, if you find that that's not a valuable goal, then you can remove that goal and include the rest in your campaign if you find them to be valuable goals to you. So I can't decide that for you. You know your campaign and you know what you're trying to achieve with your campaign, but make sure that you don't include any unnecessary goals in the campaign conversion goals, okay? I'm just gonna say continue. And usually, by the way, I just leave mine like this because every action I feel is useful to me. And that's why I leave everything here, because I've only included useful actions for myself. All right. The next thing we wanna do is choose a campaign type. Now, the first type is a search campaign. And I'm gonna show you an example of that. A search campaign is, for example, I'm gonna go to car insurance. And I am going to search Google. And as you can see, these little search results with the words in bold AD next to them, those would be your search campaigns, okay? So all of these dudes over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, those are search campaigns. These guys at the bottom, these are also search campaigns. Also notice how if I go to the second page, I get more search ads. And if I go to the third page, I'll get even more search ads. So those would be your search campaigns. Now, these are not to be confused with these types of ads. Let me just do this. These ads over here with the picture of the shoe on here and the price, those are what's called shopping ads. So they are not search ads, those are Google shopping ads, all right? So we've got our search ads out of the way. I'm gonna come back to Performance Max, and the next thing I wanna talk about is display ads. Now, display ads, you can think of display ads like banner ads, and the cool thing about these display ads is Google has over 200 million websites all across the internet where they show these display ads. So for example, if I go to Forbes.com, you see this ad over here highlighted in yellow. This would be a display ad. And as I'm scrolling down, let's look for another one. It says advertisement here, so one should be popping up shortly. Highlighted in yellow here as well. These are display ads. And I'm just gonna keep on going. Let's see if we can find any more. Any more? Here's one more. I don't even need to highlight this one in yellow. It is in yellow already. This is a display ad as well. Now, if you're the type of person who goes to Forbes regularly, you would be somebody most likely in business. And that's the cool thing about display ads, is that they capture different types of websites and also the different audiences that are attracted to those different types of websites. So let's say you're not a business type of person and you're more into real estate, more into DIY, and you're more into just buying and selling properties. Let's say you're the type of person who goes to realtor.com. Realtor.com is also on the Google Display Network, and I'll show you an example of one of the ads.
Let's see what we got here. Most valuable. Let's go here. Okay. Now, once I click on this article, notice what happens on the top right-hand side. Do you see this little image that popped up here? That's a Google display ad as well. And as I scroll around, this one here, highlighted in yellow, this would be a Google display ad as well. So as you can see, completely different website from Forbes.com, but they're still running display ads as well. And there are over 200 million of these websites, like I said before. So you will have plenty of place to find the right audience and to show your ads and to find the ads that convert most and also the placements that convert most as well, right? Next one would be your shopping ads. Now, if we go back to our running shoes example, these are all shopping ads. And how you know it's a shopping ad? It usually has a price with it, usually has a picture of the product, and you'll see that they have very standard pictures. Like, as you can see here, these are all from one brand, but even the one that says shop.adidas, it also has that same type of look to it as well. And they just go on and on and on. So these are shopping ads. Now, if you're running an e-commerce store, then you definitely want to be running shopping ads as your main campaigns and not search ads as your main campaigns, because search ads will give you a much worse return on investment than shopping ads. All right. Next up, video ads. Now, the old video ads used to show just on YouTube. And let's look for example on a video ad. Let's just look for something that's advertiser friendly. For example, I guess this dude over here. You will usually find these ads. I'm just gonna cut down the sound. Hey, guess what? YouTube doesn't want to show me ads. I found the magic cheat code. But anyway, you know those ads that, that's why, because I'm logged into my account. Hold on, let me sign out. I was wondering why this wasn't working. Okay, cool. I'm signed out now. Let's try that again. And there we go. So for example, this would be an ad, and this would be what we call an in-stream skippable YouTube ad. And you can also find them on search results. So if I say make money online, notice how you've got search results and they appear with AD next to them in YouTube. You will also find some videos with the word AD next to them in the search results. And those are also a different type of video ad as well. So if you want to advertise exclusively on platforms like YouTube and you want to really show your videos to a lot of people, then you would use video ads. Another cool thing about video ads, or I should say it's cool in principle, in practice it's slightly costly and can actually erode your conversions. But another thing about YouTube ads that you should understand is YouTube ads don't just run on YouTube. They run on all of the display network websites as well. And this is a brand new type of ad campaign. It's called a responsive ad that YouTube just introduced, and it runs across all mobile apps, it runs across websites, and it runs across display partners. And we'll get into that later on in the training, but I just want to make you aware of that. So even though you're running on YouTube, or you think you're running on YouTube, you might be running on other websites as well. Okay, next type of ad would be your discovery ad. Now, the cool thing, I just signed myself out, but anyway, it's fine. The cool thing about discovery ads is they show up on great places where you'd expect content to show up. So for example, if I go back into my Gmail account and I'm logging into my inbox right now, if I go over to the promotions tab over here, you'll see two emails highlighted here and you'll see the word AD next to them in green. These would be Gmail ads. Now they look just like every other single email that I've gotten, but these guys over here, they are actually for advertisers. So these are actually companies advertising to me. And as you can see, I've got this nice display over here. And when I click see more, I will go through to their website. So at every single stage at the customer journey, you'll be able to show them ads. So if you have somebody who searches Google a lot, you'll be able to show them an ad. If you have somebody who doesn't spend a lot of time on Google for searching for things, but they find themselves always on blogs or always on specific websites, you can show them ads. If somebody just spends all of their time in their inbox, in their email, you can show them ads. And if somebody shops online for specific products, you can show them an ad. Now, we need to discuss the last one, which is the Performance Max. So hold on 1 second. Let me just log back in. Okay, so I'm back in. And if I go to my Performance Max, what Performance Max does is it's basically a combination of every single type of Google ad combined. It'll show to search results. It'll show on the display network. It will show on shopping results. If you have an e-commerce and you're running Performance Max shopping campaigns, it'll show on video and it'll show on discovery as well. So a lot of people will say here, but Devin, if this ad does everything that all of these ads do, why don't I just run this campaign? The problem with Performance Max campaigns is you don't really have that much say over where your budget is being spent and how your budget is being spent. So for example, with a search ad, I can decide which searches I want to show up on, which searches I don't want to show up on. For display networks, I can decide which websites I want my ads to show up on, and I can decide which websites and apps I do not want my ads to show up with, usually the ones with unrelated audiences. When you do Performance Max campaigns, it's kind of like you giving Google Ads your credit card and telling them, you know what, go crazy and I hope I get conversions. You don't have any control whatsoever. So if you have spare budget that you're not afraid to lose, I would recommend that you try out Performance Max campaigns, but be very aware that these are the very difficult to control types of campaigns. And they're usually the types of campaigns that get a lot of people into trouble very quickly. I would recommend going for your search, your display, anything else, because over there we have more of a say of how our money is getting spent. With Performance Max, we don't whatsoever. So that's every single type of Google ad explained. And remember, you also get retargeting ads whereby somebody will go onto your website, they will see your product or your offer, and they will leave. And we can also show ads to them to bring them back onto your website as well. So you're pretty sorted out in terms of all the tools available to you when it comes to using Google Ads. And a lot of people ask me, hey, Devin, what is your favorite type of Google ad? I would say retargeting ads are my number one, and my number two are search ads, purely because they have the highest conversion rate and they give you the most control over your budget as well.
So you might have noticed, or the eagle eye amongst you might have noticed, that at parts I was talking about training. Now, what did I mean by that? Basically, that snippet that you just heard, that was taken out of my Google Ads training for entrepreneurs. So what we do is we teach you a very fast way to scale up your Google Ads and just basically get good at running Google Ads for your business. Now, if you're interested in that, I'm gonna leave a link in the description below. We've got 11 hours of Google Ads content where we teach you every single thing there is to know and that you should know about Google Ads. And we kind of leave out the complicated stuff. So none of this weird computer techie stuff, only the important things that you need to know to get clients online. So make sure you check that out, like I said, at the link in the description below. So I just want to thank you so much for watching this video to the end, and be sure to like and subscribe, share with a friend if you haven't already. And also, I want you to check out our Google Ads playlist. If you're brand new to Google Ads, watch this playlist over here. We've got a whole bunch of videos that's going to help you on your journey. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time. Peace.